Hello friends, in the last video on multivariate analysis, we had seen the introduction of multivariate analysis, some of the important concepts used in it, and the introduction of various tools and techniques as a part of it. In this video, we are going to learn the first tool in multivariate analysis in Minitab software with the help of a practical example for easy understanding and better clarity. So let's begin. Principal component analysis. The principal component analysis is used to identify a smaller number of uncorrelated variables, also called principal components, from a large set of data. With this analysis, you create new variables, also called as principal components, that are linear combinations of the observed variables. The goal of the principal component analysis is to explain the maximum amount of variance with the fewest number of principal components. For example, a bank requires 8 sections of information from loan applicants, like income, education level, age, length of the time at current residence, length of time with the current employer, savings, debt, and number of credit cards. A bank administrator wants to analyze this data to determine the best way to group and report it. The administrator collects this information for 30 loan applicants. Here, the administrator performs a principal component analysis to reduce the number of variables to make the data easier to analyze. The administrator wants enough components to explain at least 90% of the variation in the data. Data considerations for principal component analysis. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect the data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. In the case of principal component analysis, there is only one requirement of data, and that is you should have at least two variables, and the measurements for each variable should be recorded in separate numeric columns. Example of principal component analysis. Let's continue with the same example. A bank requires 8 sections of information from loan applicants, like income, education level, age, length of time at current residence, length of time with current employer, savings, debt, and the number of credit cards. A bank administrator wants to analyze this data to determine the best way to group and report it. The administrator collects this information for 30 loan applicants. Here, the administrator performs a principal component analysis to reduce the number of variables to make the data easier to analyze. The administrator wants enough components to explain at least 90% of the variation in the data. Conduct a principal component analysis in Minitab. To conduct a principal component analysis in Minitab, please follow these steps. 1. Enter or copy the data to Minitab worksheet with the data for one variable in one column, as shown in the picture. 2. Select stat, multivariate, and then principal components. 3. In variables, enter C1 to C8. 4. In the number of components to compute, keep the field blank. Here, enter the number of principal components that you want Minitab to calculate. If you have a large number of variables, then you may want to specify a smaller number of components to reduce the amount of output. If you do not know how many components to enter, then you can leave this field as a blank. 5. In type of matrix, keep the default selection of correlation as it is. Here, please select the correct type of matrix to use to calculate the principal components. Correlation. This is used when your variables have different scales and you want to weight all the variables equally. Our example falls in this category. And covariance. This is used when your variables use the same scale or when your variables have the different scales but you want to give more emphasis to variables with higher variances. 6. From the graphs, select the graphs you want to see for analysis. Scriplot. Use a scriplot to identify the number of components that explain the most of the variation in the data. Score plot for first two components. Use the score plot to look for clusters, trends, and outliers in the first two principal components. Loading plot for first two components. Use the loading plot to visually interpret the first two principal components. Biplot for first two components. Use the biplot to look for clusters, trends, and outliers through the interpretation of the first two principal components. The biplot overlays the score plot and the loading plot on the same graph. And outlier plot. Use the outlier plot to identify outliers in the data. And 7. Click OK in each dialog box to get the results. We will get the results of analysis in the session window and in graph window. Interpretation of results. In these results, use the cumulative proportion to determine the amount of variance that the principal components explain. Retain the principal components that explain an acceptable level of variance. The acceptable level depends on your application. For descriptive purposes, you may only need 80% of the variance explained. However, if you want to perform other analysis on the data, you may want to have at least 90% of the variance explained by the principal components. This is the case in our example. The first four principal components explain 90.17% of the variation in the data. Therefore, the administrator decides to use these components to analyze the loan applicants. You can also use the size of the eigenvalue to determine the number of principal components. Retain the principal components with the largest eigenvalue, that is greater than 1. The scriplot orders the eigenvalues from largest to smallest. The ideal pattern is a steep curve, followed by a bend and then a straight line. Use the components in the steep curve before the point that starts the line trend. The loading plot visually shows the results for the first two components. Age, residence, employ, and savings have large positive loadings on component 1. So, these component measures long-term financial stability. Debt and credit cards have large negative loadings on component 2. So, this component primarily measures an applicant's credit history. Use the outlier plot to identify outliers. Any point that is above the reference line is an outlier. Outliers can significantly affect the results of your analysis. In these results, there are no outliers. All the points are below the reference line. The first principal component accounts for 44.3% of the total variance. The variables that correlate the most with the first principal components are age 0.484, residence 0.466, employ 0.459, and savings 0.404. The first principal component is positively correlated with all four of these variables. Therefore, increasing the value of age, residence, employ, and savings increases the value of first principal component. This is all about the detailed illustration of principal component analysis. We will see the next type of multivariate tools with a practical example in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful, add your valuable comments, and share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.